Good afternoon, Word of Grace family. Today is Wednesday, September the 9th, 2020, and welcome to today's edition of 5 Minutes of Encouragement. As usual, the scriptures that I reference during this talk will be in the description box of this video. I ask that you both like and share this hashtag 5 Minutes of Encouragement. For today's encouragement, family, I'd like to ask the question, how were you sanctified? That is assuming that you know that you are sanctified. Well, I'm here to tell you, yes, family, you are sanctified. How were you sanctified? You know, let's take a quick little detour. We're going to jump off into the book of Ephesians. Actually, it's not a detour, it's the main point. We're going to jump off into the book of Ephesians. In chapter 5 are some very cool verses we want to look at for today's encouragement. Starting in verse 25, he's talking about husbands loving your wives. Now, usually when I read this scripture, the women just run through the church and kick over pews and run up and down the aisles because that's right, you love me like Christ loved the church and gave himself for her. Yes, I understand. Let's look at the verse first before y'all get happy. And to the husbands, you are to demonstrate love for your wives with the same tender devotion that Christ demonstrated to us, his bride. For he died for us, sacrificing himself. And again, like I said, women just run and kick and scream throughout the church. However, just before that, the Apostle Paul, under the guiding of the Holy Spirit, addressed you ladies too, back in verse 22. Let's take a look at that. For wives, this means being supportive to your husbands, like you are tenderly devoted to our Lord. So, hey, that's right. Now men are flipping around, running laps around the field, saying, that's right, you know, be devoted to me like you are to Christ. Then Paul says something very important. So you could read those verses and thinks that the Holy Spirit is trying to get you to have a happy and successful marriage, which, let me say, that is the goal, I believe, of heaven, is for there to be happy, successful husband-wife pairs all over the country. But Paul says, no, this is actually a mystery. And what is that mystery? Let's jump down to verse 32, I believe, and we'll start reading there. Marriage is a beautiful design of the Almighty, a great and sacred mystery meant to be a vivid example of Christ and his church. See, it's so cool. See, he's utilizing marriage between a man and a wife, or a man and his wife, to be a type and shadow of the relationship that Jesus has with the church. Now, don't forget the question that we're asking, how were you sanctified, assuming that you know that you're sanctified. Let's jump into the book of Corinthians, a wonderful scripture, which again, utilizing Christ and the church, husband and wife, utilizing Christ and the church as a substance, while marriage here on the earth is the shadow of it. So using Christ and the church as the substance, let's look in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 7, I believe. For the unbelieving husband is what? Sanctified by the wife, and the unbelieving wife is sanctified by the husband. Otherwise, your children will be unclean, but now they are holy. So what we learn in that passage right there is that, and this, he's talking about an unbelieving spouse being with a believing spouse. And he says, don't worry, the believing spouse actually sanctifies the whole marriage. In our case, the believing spouse is Christ himself. And because we're married to him, Christ sanctified us. It's just it's because of our relationship with him. Absolutely nothing you did. Absolutely nothing I did. We didn't earn it, which means, guess what? We can't unearn it. So, family, I want you to rest in the fact that you are sanctified and holy, and you, all of this was done in you and to you for the benefit of Christ himself, so that his bride would be on the same footing as him. Now, we skipped a little bit of text there back in the book of Ephesians. We're going to go through and reread that text. We're going to jump back into the New King James because it does use the word sanctified there. So I'm going to jump back into the New King James, back in Ephesians 5, and then we'll talk in just a second. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her up, dust yourself off, and keep marching toward the goal. Why? Because we have been made right because we are married to the right one. Family, I hope this has been a huge source of encouragement for you today. As usual, I absolutely love and adore each and every one of you. But more importantly, Jesus loves you. Go make it a great day, family. We'll see you back here tomorrow.